You know, COVID has dealt everybody a hard blow. I was getting concerned about how banks, credit unions, and other financial institutions were managing. Then I read here in the paper that they're stable. And from the latest financial stability report, my money is safe. To find out about what was in this report, keep watching this week's episode of CBB 101.
Good day and welcome to CBB 101. Starting this week and continuing for the next few weeks, we will distill the findings of the 2020 Financial Stability Report. The FSR is a publication of the Central Bank of Barbados, the Barbados Deposit Insurance Corporation, and the Financial Services Commission. The document assesses the health of the players in the financial services sector, including commercial banks, finance and trust companies, mutual funds, pension funds, credit unions, and insurance companies. I'm Noveline Brewster, and joining me today to provide a synopsis of the 2020 report is Carlon Walks, senior economist at the Central Bank of Barbados and head of the bank's financial stability unit. Welcome, Carlon. How are you?
I am fine, thanks.
It's good to see you.
And yourself?
I am excellent. No complaints. Thank you very much. Give us a synopsis of the performance.
Okay, I'm Noveline. Well, as a whole, the sector was stable. However, stability was somewhat compromised by the COVID-19 pandemic. Assets of all segments of the system grew, with the exception of finance and trust companies. Non-performing loans, which is pretty much an indicator of the credit risk, has grown for all segments of lenders. Profitability waned for the credit unions, the finance and trust companies, the life insurance and pension fund companies. On the brighter side, the system was liquid as a whole, and we don't have any risk to depositors being unable to access their funds.
So you described the system as stable. What do we mean when we say the system is stable?
Well, it's stable in that it's working well. The financial infrastructure is sound, such as the payment systems and what's not. Financial intermediation is running smoothly, and that is the flow of funds from savers to borrowers. It's working well. The system is stable.
And as you said earlier, no risk to depositors and...
Precisely, and capital adequacy is well above the regulatory requirements.
Explain for us how the financial services sector was able to weather the storm in 2020, a year that was characterized by a pandemic, high unemployment, economic crisis almost. Help us understand.
Well, that's a very good question, Noveline. I would have to say the first and most important factor that led to the system being able to sustain the shock of COVID-19 would be the liquidity in the system. It was well above the requirements. It was growing for commercial banks for quite some time. And as a result, the institutions were able to finance the moratoria programs as well as their day-to-day operations. And that would have constituted for the main reason why the sector remained resilient during this time. Another very important factor would be the fact that they work from home arrangements, being that financial institutions and other firms were able to allow their staff to work from home, the safety of their homes, and business could continue to run, and the financial system was able to work even during such perilous times.
Give us an idea, Carlon, as to how excessive was the liquidity in the system, and what does that say about the consumers in the financial services sector?
It has been growing for quite some time, especially in the commercial bank sector. And what that means is that there is enough cash for depositors to access their deposits, and there's enough cash to engage in investments if need be, and to sustain shocks such as COVID. And that would have really come about as a result the fact that there's been a steady growth in deposits over the years. And for the past 3 years or so, loans has been declining. So you will have that increase in cash balances as time progresses.
So is it safe to say that Barbadians have been saving?
Barbadians indeed has been saving. And not borrowing as much.
Yes. What does this performance tell us generally about the strength of the Barbadian financial services sector?
Well, it tells us that we are resilient. However, we can't afford to let our guards down because, as I would have mentioned earlier, the COVID-19 pandemic would have still dealt a pretty significant blow to the system. And depending on the length of time it takes for the economy to recover, we can see a worsening of the situation. So we still need to be vigilant and, you know, to make sure that banks are well capitalized and have sufficient liquidity buffers.
But as you said, they are sufficiently capitalized.
Yes, they are.
Carlon, in 2020, the financial services sector grew by 3% to represent 285% of this country's gross domestic product. Help our country understand the significance of this huge percentage of GDP that the financial services sector represents.
Just think about assets. So we have the assets of the financial sector, which have to be large enough to cover our deposits, pension benefits. It needs to be large enough to cover the usual insurance claims that are made. So this figure has been accumulating over a period of time. So it is a stock value. Whereas you have GDP, which accrues over a 12-month period in this instance. And the difference is understandable because GDP is the value added associated with the production of goods and services during a period of time. And you have a value that has been accumulating since the existence of the financial services sector. It's quite similar to a household who would have accumulated cars, land, houses, and different assets. And that value of the household assets could very well be more than 100% of the annual income of the household. If you understand. So that is how it is.
Yes, I do.
And GDP is a common measure, is a common base used to measure the movement of things because GDP is the most readily available indicator of size of the economy. So that's why we use GDP. What is more important with that ratio is the movement and not necessarily the level. Mm-hmm.
This raises another question in my mind, and it is, Carlon, to what extent does the erosion of the GDP in 2020 contribute to this ratio that we're discussing?
Yeah, a large part because GDP would have contracted, and this is real GDP, but nominal GDP also contracted by a pretty large number. GDP would have contracted by 18%. And you have that coupled with a 3% increase in assets. So you have the top number, the numerator growing, and the bottom number declining. So what is going to happen, you're going to have a larger end result, a larger ratio at the end of the day. So it did contribute significantly. Probably was the largest contributor to the ratio reaching that level.
Okay, Carlon, the report speaks to how highly interconnected the financial services sector is in Barbados. Mm-hmm. Explain for our viewers exactly what we mean by this interconnectedness.
Okay, we mean that almost, I could say all, other segments of the financial system hold deposits in the commercial banking system. So, for that reason, the commercial bank is a major source of interconnectivity in the system. And what that really has implications for is that if there is a challenge in the commercial banking system, it will have ripple effects on to the other segments. Because if for some reason they run short on cash, then the commercial banks, the credit unions, and some of the finance and trust companies wouldn't be able to access their money.
What level of monitoring do you do?
We look at the movements in the assets and the liabilities of the financial system. We look at the non-performing loans, capital adequacy, the liquidity provisions as a percentage of NPLs, and a host of other indicators we look at. One thing we also look at is those special mention borrowers, those who are not yet non-performing. For instance, those who are not late by 90 days or more, but they may be late by a few days or weeks or a month. So we would also monitor those to see how large that segment of borrowers is growing, because that could then have implications for our credit and by extension default risk.
Finally, Carlon, just remind us of the major strengths of the financial services sector as revealed in the 2020 Financial Stability Report.
So the major strengths would be liquidity and capital adequacy. The major concern would be the default risk.
Okay. That's
as shown by the non-performing loans ratio.
Okay, that's a good place to wrap, Carlon, because next week we're going to be looking at the concerns or the challenges that the report identified. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's leave you now with our key takeaways.
The 2020 Financial Stability Report showed that Barbados' financial services sector remained stable. Commercial banks continue to be well capitalized with substantial liquidity, and the liquidity in the system ensured that the sector was able to withstand the challenges caused by the COVID-19 pandemic.
The key challenge is NPLs, non-performing loans. Those are loans that are late by at least 90 days. Those are the key challenges given the COVID crisis. It has affected the customer's ability to repay debt.
Thanks for tuning in. Hit the buttons below to like and share this episode, and join us next time when we look at some of the challenges that confronted the financial services sector in 2020. See you then.
CBB 101, economics about you and me. CBB 101, economics about you and me.